Hey everybody, I wanted to put a special dedication video together for my good friend Brian Swink, who you guys all know is a complete legend from the Supercross scene, the motocross scene. He's a two-time 125 champion, and he was an absolute legend on a motorcycle. And as you know, Brian passed away, and he was a good dear friend of mine who I kept in touch with. He rode for our team back in 97 for Moto Triple X. And yeah, it's just like I'm saying, I really wanted to put this video together for him and show that there was a lot of people out there that cared for him. So please sit back and take a look at this video. And we love you, Brian. Rest in peace.
So I remember Brian as 257, I think it was, when he was racing the 80s. And I was a 125 novice at the time. So he was 80 expert and just pretty much killing everyone and had the sweet style and all that. And then lo and behold, what, 3-4 years later, we were teammates on one of the historical pro circuit teams, Team Peak, back in the day. And I was the West Coast rider and he was the East Coast. He started winning Supercross. Then I started winning Supercross, and I think we pretty much had a powerhouse team. It was always a pleasure to ride with Brian. You know, he was always pretty wild, great style on the bike, and yeah, we're sure gonna miss him for sure. My condolences go out to the family, his kids, of course, and I wish circumstances could be different, but what a champion.
Brian Swink, you were a legend back in the day, and you'll live on. Rest in peace. And my condolences go out to your family. Brian Swink was a legend, badass on a 125, two championships, right, in Supercross, and yeah, hope that rest in peace. Good dude.
Brian Swink, one of the all-time greats of the sport, my biggest hero growing up. I spent all my time in Florida. The first time I ever got a chance to ride a Supercross track was at Brian's house in Florida. Before he even came out, he was still talking to my mom. Jump to jump. Cased, wrist through the skin, first compound fracture, walked back over. He's like, I told you not to ride the Supercross track. I was 11, I was like, but it was so much fun. And just being a Suzuki guy, being in Florida, being the only guy that year that came out and just put it to Jeremy McGrath, guy's a legend. And definitely appreciate everything that Brian did to help grow the sport and everything that he allowed me to do at his facility. And even film Moto Triple X, dude's a legend.
Sad day today, but you know, for one of my best friends and also a family member, Swink meant a lot to all of us. If you knew him from the 90s and stuff, he was a stud, was a trendsetter, and changed a lot of people's lives and the way they look at racing, and also how we hung as friends. You know, we have a good group of friends that have been really close, and luckily I was close to Brian and became part of his family when I married his cousin, and he's been great. Just sad, bummed, but I know he would want us all to have a good time and keep racing on, so love you, bro.
I just would like to tell his parents that I'm sorry that this happened to Brian, and I do have something at my house that is really something that was given to me by him and Marshall Plum. I have a number one plate signed by both of them. So, you know, I hope everything works out for you folks, and you know, that's a nice young man that's just ended his life way too soon. So that's all I can say. It's been a bad month in the industry. So Godspeed.
Brian Swink, the Swinkster, bad dude on a dirt bike. I got to know Brian really well. I was on Factory Suzuki with him, and it was a pleasure of mine to be able to become good friends with him. I used to watch him going through the amateur ranks. He was winning races, 257 from Michigan, the Michigan Mafia, the originator. Bad dude, man. He did things on a dirt bike that I don't think people will ever do or maybe ever do again. Jean-Michel Bell used to come up to him when Bell was factory Honda, walk over to the Suzuki pits and talk to Swinkster and ask him about different lines on the track, and just because he was so talented. Awesome guy. But besides racing, you know, he was a good friend of mine, and it was awesome hanging out with him. He he'll be missed, and it's unfortunate how things worked out for the Swinkster, but we can learn from him on and off the track, and he'll definitely be missed. I lost a good friend when Swinkster passed away, and I pray for his family.
Hey, sorry to hear about Brian. Totally respected that guy. He was, when he obviously won our first race for us when we had a race team. He honestly was one of the most determined riders I've ever seen ride a bike, along with talent as well. I can remember if he had a bad practice even or a bad race, being so pissed off it wasn't even funny. You couldn't get around him, and he usually fixed it. But great guy. Sorry to hear about it, but always, I'll always remember him, and that's for sure.
Hi, Mike Brown here. You know, about Brian Swink, I spent a lot of time with him over the years being on the same team. You know, I spent, a few months with him living in Florida. You know, I learned a lot from that guy. He's, you know, he's one of the best talented riders that's ever rode a motorcycle, you know. And the thing about him, you know, he did his own thing. You know, he didn't, had no worries in the world. That's the main thing. You know, he didn't care what people thought about him. He did his own thing, had fun. You know, and like I said, I learned a lot from the guy. You know, he's, like I said, he's talented, and, you know, he's been missed, and, you know, went through a lot of hard times, but at the end of the day, you know, he's still one of the best riders, and, you know, it's been a good time spending with him, for sure. You know, rest in peace, Brian, and we miss you a lot.
Brian Swink was a legend, and I always enjoyed watching him. He always sent it, and was always down for a good time, is what I heard. So you always got to respect a guy like that.
Brian, I remember the first time I met you, we were riding for Team Green Kawasaki. Showed up at 83, I think, pre-production bike weekend. We were riding the pre-production bikes in Ponca City. Showed up. Some wiry kid with a cross around his neck, looking all Guido, but he wasn't a Guido. And I thought, I had never seen a kid that young with a chain on his neck like that. But I'm sure you weren't the epitome of style, but at that time I thought, what a stylish kid. Anyhow, had a pleasure racing against you over the years. Many battles, one in Tennessee that I'll never forget in the stock class. It was 20 minutes of fury with you. On to, in my mind, later on in your professional career, I still tell everybody Brian Swink was a true badass and invented the seat bounce.
Brian Swink was a legend. I grew up watching him race with my dad. I think they were teammates. Always heard how fast he was. I was little when he was at his prime, but I heard how much of a badass he was. So, you know, it's a legend, and a legend to live on.
Man, the Swinkster. From his days, riding mini bikes and his legendary battles with the Budman to Peak Honda and Suzuki, and later life with the shaved head and goatee, he pretty much did it his own way, and he never really gave a fuck what anybody thought about him. And you know, for me, that was one of his most endearing qualities. One of the years we were into Europe, we were in Paris, I think we were on a bus, and we were all driving back to from the airport. There was probably like 20 of us, and everybody had to piss, so we convinced the bus driver to stop, and everybody jumped off. We're all peeing on the side of this hill, and I run back, grab my camera, and it's like a box camera from Kodak or something. And I run back and yell at everybody, smile, fuckers! And Swink turns around, gives me the bird, and he's got his shaved head, or not shaved head, his little bowl cut he had. I don't know, man, I miss the guy. He was a good guy, did his own way, and Godspeed, Swinkster. I'll miss you.
Yeah, Swink was a legend. I mean, I'm sure everyone's saying that right now, but I didn't know him on a personal level, but you know, a guy like that has an impact on a lot of people, and it's really sad to see somebody like that pass. But the legacy will go on.
When I first used to hang out at Blackburn's in Florida, Brian's place is about 3 miles away. We used to go over there, ride my dual bike over and watch those guys play. One day I went over to find the guys. I couldn't find them. They were all in the house watching porn.
drive up and stand.
Godspeed.
Hey guys. Hey, one who obviously never got to saw Brian race, but listened to a podcast and seemed like a real badass dude. He liked his mentality and has never say die effort. So want to give my condolences to his family and rest easy.
Hey, Dave Dye here. So I worked for Brian Swink, 1997, for Moto Triple X, and man, great guy. Talented dude. One of my good friends. We hung out a bunch in Florida, had some good times. You knew where you stood with him at all times. Couldn't ask for more than that. Spent a lot of time with him and Newmack in Florida. Kenneth Jones. Great memories. Small balls. I mean, we could go on and on and on. So, you know, missed the dude a lot. Talked to him off and on the phone. On Facebook, stuff like that, and didn't know, hit me hard, but rest in peace, Brian.
When I think of Brian, I think about all the, my younger years, you know, and I used to look up to that guy. I mean, literally, he was my hero. I have pictures of us together when I was like, I don't know, man, 8 years old or something, and one of the pictures that rings out is the picture of him and I at World Mini. Long time ago, like 1988, and the guy was my hero. He was from the East Coast, so I watched him throughout his career. And you know, when he rode for Peak, Mitch Payton, it was awesome. The guy was just killing it. And on to Suzuki, and I was always just a huge fan of his style. And you know, he was always generous to me and gave me a lot of advice when I was a youngster coming up. But I'm definitely gonna miss the guy for sure. You know, I think about him a lot and think about the good times that we had, and he's gonna be missed for sure, but I'll never forget about him, and gonna miss you, bud. Rest in peace.
I was lucky enough to know Brian from back in the Baja Acres days. He was growing up Team Green. Have to put him up there with Eddie Hicks, Buddy Antonez, Damon Bradshaw, fastest mini bike riders I think I've ever seen. What happened in his early pro career, I thought we'd see that for a long time, but you know, Brian rolled his own way and decided that he wasn't going to be corporate, wasn't going to be factory, and did things his own way. He was literally punk rock before all of us were. And he's sorely missed, and I hope people remember him for what he was. That's one of the fastest 125 riders in the 90s.
Remember the Swinkster back in the day and Factory Suzuki when I was there, and me and Phil Lawrence, we saw come down and hang out. Good times down there in Florida. Gonna miss you, buddy.
So yeah, the Swinkster, he was always fun to work with as a journalist, especially towards the end of his career when he was on Moto Triple X. I will never forget the gold, or no, his was silver, I think, right? It was the silver glitter bike at Washougal. He's a rad dude, always good for a good quote. Funny guy for sure. Gonna miss him.
Thinking back on Brian Swink brings you back to the best years of my racing career as far as having fun was 97, 98, Moto Triple X days. We really were just rebelling against everything. And I think Swink had that personality that really was just a guy who wanted to be himself and not change for anyone, more of a rebel, and really helped the start of freestyle motocross. He was one of the first guys to really do tricks on dirt bikes. Had the rebel attitude and just was a badass racer, like was such a good talent, and you know, it was awesome just to share those memories with him, and you know, it's cool. So a lot of respect to him, and he'll always be remembered for sure.
Sad day, you know, we've lost way too many lately, and you know, hearing another name, especially a name that's close to me, you know, that was right in my era. You know, we had a lot of laughs, a lot of fights, a lot of everything through the years. So, you know, God bless you. Rest in peace, my friend.
It's Eli Tomac out at Glen Helen. Just want to say condolences to the whole Brian Swink family and friends. You know, it was a legend in many ways, probably more even off the motorcycle. So, you know, guys, stay strong.
Hey, Brian. Bummed to hear about the way things turned out. It's always great working with you. Always thought you were a really, really humble, cool guy, really committed to your racing, and sad what happened. But, hey, you had a great run, man. Peace out.
Yes, I heard the bad news about Brian Swink, the Swinkster. And I tell you, I have some great memories about Brian, riding with him, battling with him. He was a great rider, great guy. I loved, you know, loved talking to him. It's been a while, man. I got great memories about Brian. He's a legend.
Today's a sad day, man. I lost a good friend. The industry lost a great superstar, man. I mean, nobody in the 90s that followed motocross didn't know Brian Swink. And like I said, man, I've been around for a long time now, and I've always been friends with Swinkster. We've been there a long time. He's a good friend, man, and just his loss day, it really is heartfelt, man, and I just miss the guy. Love him to death.
Hey everybody, Jeff Emick here, out at Glen Helen Raceway, a place where Brian and I raced many a times, especially back in our 125 days. He was riding for Mitch Payton and Bones and everybody on Pro Circuit, those peak 125 days when he was pretty dominant in 125 Supercross. He was an animal, just an absolute warrior on the motorcycle. Brian would race you hard, and he expected to get raced hard in return, and it was always a lot of fun, and I'm sure gonna miss those Swinksters, so rest in peace, buddy.
What's up, Jason Anderson here. Just wanted to talk about, you know, the legend Swink, Brian Swink. It's kind of a bummer, but you know, he was a badass, and we'll always remember that.
Hey, look, I'm Jason Wagon. I announced the motocross races on TV, but when I was growing up, Brian Swink, I was a Suzuki guy. I grew up riding Suzuki, so I was always rooting for him, like, big time. And then he came to the races one time wearing, like, a goatee, which was before goatees were cool, and a shaved head, and they were calling him Fu Manchu on TV, and I was like, this dude's got the style, he's got the look, he's got the attitude, he's got the Suzuki, and he's got the titles. So I was always a big fan. So obviously, sad to hear what happened, but I'll forever remember the good stuff that happened on the racetrack. He was a legend, absolutely, and as far as talent and skill and just a fun guy to watch on and off the track and on the motorcycle, never forget.
All right, Swinkster, I dug the guy, I loved the guy, man. We spent a lot of time together. We traveled and went around. I went to his house and spent time with his mom and dad, man. They're a great, great guy, great family. I mean, he's gonna be missed by so many of his fans. I mean, he's got a huge following, and you know, makes me sad, you know. I wish the guy wasn't where he is, you know. And just the industry lost a good guy, and that's what it is.
That's perfect.
No, I was on Team Suzuki with Brian in 1993, and we were teammates. And Brian was always sort of a quiet guy. He did his own thing, his own way. That was the Swinkster style, you know, his way, which I can appreciate and respect. And hung out with him at his house in Florida, rode there with him, and he was all around. He was a good guy. He was a good guy, just to himself. And you know, like I said, he just did his things his way, Brian's way. And you know, it's a shame we lost him. And you know, he'll definitely be missed in the sport. He made an impact on the sport, that's for sure. God bless him. Godspeed.
All right. So we're talking about Brian Swink. Amazing kid. Rode for me in 91. He was the guy that got our very first win on the team. And he got the first championship of our team. I loved him. Like, he was just a special rider. Like, there was things he did on the track that would blow people away. It's a different guy. Like, one time we went testing at Paris and he said he was going home. I said, okay. So, thought I'd see him in 2 days. Next day, I asked his mechanic, where's Brian at? Drove home to Michigan. And I'm like, bastard? And I'm like, he didn't tell me. He just said, I'm going home. And I thought he meant for the day, but he meant going home. So, always fun to have him around. Great rider. He liked boxing too. But he'll be missed.
All right, to all the family of Brian Swink, my biggest condolences to you guys. I hope you guys get through this okay. I'm really sorry to hear that, obviously, but you know, sometimes things don't go the way that we want to, but I wish you guys all the best and all the love in the world. You guys will get through this, and hope better days are ahead.
All right, just gonna miss you, Brian. We're wished I got to see you a little more. You came and hung out at the races. I know you felt like maybe you were not in a good spot, didn't want to come here and hang out, but we would like to see you a little more. And bummed I don't get to say goodbye to you, and I don't know, just all of us not being able to really be around there to help you like you needed. And hopefully you're in a better place, and I know you made a lot of people really sad. I wish you got to see that, actually. You probably don't know that all these people care about you so much. So anyway, you definitely were a super talented rider. You were a really cool dude. And man, just wish that everybody got to see the real you and not all these stories that people talk now. So anyway, we're gonna miss you a lot. And again, wish I got to see you more and reached out to you more. I didn't call you enough myself, so that's guilty on me too. So I need to do better with other people that I'm friends with. So anyway, we're gonna miss you.
I didn't know Swink that well, but I got to watch him ride countless times. And a lot of people were really negative on him. They thought he was some kind of a nasty outlaw guy or something because of the way he looked. You know, he shaved his head and he had a beard. Of course, now everybody does. He had tattoos. Now he'd be normal. But I'll be honest with you. He was a good guy. And he was a nice man. And he had a really cute girlfriend. But he was a really great rider, too. And I think it's forgotten how fast he was. He was really, really talented. He could win Supercross in motocross races. But aside from that, when I heard the news the other day, I'm just really sad to see him go. We like this Swink. I can tell you what, everybody at the races liked him too. He's a good, a little different than the rest of the group. Frankly, we need a few more like him. So long, Swinkster.
Brian Swink was certainly my first hero. Amongst all of my racing peers growing up in Michigan, we all looked up to him. His riding was next level. I mean, like, a lot of people have that feeling when they watch Bubba Stewart, like, oh my gosh, that was the Brian Swink was the only other person besides Stewart that I had that oh my gosh feeling about watching them ride. He did things on the bike that I didn't know were necessarily possible, and we grew up in places that had sand tracks and such. It wasn't necessarily like a bunch of jumps that he was doing that were sweet. So yeah, I definitely kept a close eye on him all through when I was young and coming up the end of his amateur career and the early pro career. He was always super cool to me. As an amateur, he came around my track a couple times. He was always someone that I really looked up to, and just gonna miss him.
Hello there, just Johnny O'Mara, just thinking of Brian Swink here, and how we just want to, you know, have him rest in peace. He just was such a pivotal part of the sport, and as I knew him from a young kid, just shredding on motorcycles like he did, and he's really, truly missed by me personally and my family. Let Brian rest in peace. Thank you.
Wanted to give a huge shout out to Brian Swink. You know, he passed away recently, and just wanted to say rest in peace. You know, I never got to meet Brian personally, but I've heard so many good things about him from, you know, the PC guys, and, you know, he was a legend. I mean, I got to watch his races on, you know, YouTube and stuff, and he was such a badass on a 125, and seemed like a great guy, a person that I think I would have got along with. But unfortunately, passed away too soon.
What's up? I'm Justin Hill. Just wanted to say I was saddened to hear the news about Brian Swink, and my heart goes out to his family, and he's a legend. He'll be missed.
Rest in peace, Swinkster. Remember watching you in Motriplex. First guy to do a real can-can over Redbud. Walker's lead. Bad dude. Rest in peace, bro.
Brian and I grew up racing from a super young age on mini bikes. And we only saw each other a couple times a year, you know, at the big races, like World Minis and Ponca, Loretta's, that types of thing. But, you know, he was, you know, super badass. I remember having a race with him at Ponca City on 60s, my last year in 60s, that we went first and second. And, you know, he was gnarly to race against when we were, you know, 10 and 11 years old, you know, kind of grew up, and we both graduated up to pro class kind of at the same time, and he, you know, had some instant success and won some championships, and you know, faster than I did. And, you know, I remember battling with him. I got my first Supercross win, having to beat him at Charlotte in 92, and you know, it was a great accomplishment winning the race, but, you know, he was reigning champion at the time, you know, and had been pretty much undefeated that whole season. So it was like an extra feather in your cap to beat the guy. And, you know, he was always so good on a bike, and, you know, we got to become teammates and kind of closer friends when we were both at Suzuki there in the middle 90s. You know, I used to think, you know, what he used to do at Rocco's League, doing the, you know, the no-footed cans and stuff like that off it was pretty cool. And I remember that off season learning how to do can-cans and stuff. So when we went to the European Supercross races, I could do the jump contest. But, you know, Brian was an innovator and, you know, just a badass on the bike and, you know, try to be that big tough guy off the bike, but he actually was pretty cool and chill to hang out with, you know, and I think a lot of people didn't get to see that side of him, you know, and it's super sad that he got taken away from all of us so young, and yeah, I wish he would have known, you know, how important he was to the whole motorcycling community.
Brian Swing, you are a legend. Rest in peace.
Too bad about Brian, what happened to him. The guy was such a talented, good rider, and I remember when we started working with him in on the 125s. He did one coast and Jeremy did the other coast, and we testing at Simi Valley together, and often he was faster than Jeremy, and you know, the guy was so talented, but too bad what happened to him, and you know, I wish the best to his family, and try to keep the good memories.
Hey Brian, man, we miss you here at Glen Helen. We still praying for you and your family, and God bless you and your family, bro.
First met the Swinkster in 92. He was Suzuki in Las Vegas. And we became tight, you know, right off the get, because we're both champions in different sports. So we look at the world the same way. You know, I got the same issues, but it's a sad, sad deal for me when I heard what happened. And I hope his family's okay and everything like that. He'll never be forgotten. He's the king of the seat mounts, and a king in my mind is my friend too. So it's a sad thing, and I hope he's in a happy place up there. I love you, Swink, and I'm running Swink on my pants the rest of my motocross career, even though I wasn't as good as you, brother.
Hey everybody, I have a little story of myself and Brian Swink. It's a sad thing, but we battled back in 1991 in the Florida series, and we had some battles, and we went into the first East Coast 125 race, the headliners of winning that race, going into Orlando Supercross. And during the day, I heard he went to Waffle House and got a big steak for lunch. And I'm like, oh man, this guy's just eating nothing, eating a big steak, he's gonna be slow. Well, we battled through the race. I passed him last corner. He went around the outside and beat me by just a tire, by a knobby, and he won the first Supercross of the year. And that always stuck out in my mind, because the guy could eat anything, barely train, barely ride, and just be so fast, phenomenal, and beat all of us that watched everything we ate and trained all day long. So Swinkster, you were amazing, man. You were phenomenal, and it's a sad, sad loss, but I'm glad I could battle with you and call you a friend.
Brian Swink, you're a fucking badass. I'm out.
Great man, great friend. Was blessed to call him a friend. If you were lucky enough to call him a friend, which I'm blessed too, a lot of people were acquaintance with Brian. But Brian was a great person. He'd give the shirt off his back to somebody. You know, there's been many a times, I can think of a few times, when he was out here in California, when we'd go someplace and there'd be a homeless guy, you know, and Brian would help him out. He would give his shirt off his back to anybody. He didn't want any accolades or praise for what he did. That's just the type of man he was. You know, and I traveled the world with Brian. I had a lot of funny, funny stories. One that I'll never forget was when we were in Mexico and I brought water with me. And he was asking me why I brought water, and I told him. And later that night, he was chewing on ice cubes, laughing at me, calling me a sissy, saying he's a badass from Michigan and ain't nothing gonna take him down. Well, later that night or the next morning, all hell broke loose, and it lasted all through the weekend. We had so many laughs about that. Brian was all about having a good time and laughs. So that's the way I'm going to keep him in my mind. You'll be missed, Brian. Rest in peace, brother. Love you.
Zach Osborne here. Just want to give all the best and my condolences to the family of Brian Swink. I've watched him in a lot of races and a lot of Moto Triple X videos back in the day when I was a little kid. So real bummer to see him go. And yeah, all the best.
Yeah, Swinkster, man, you were a badass on a dirt bike. We're all going to miss you here. Yeah, have fun up in the sky. We'll be right back.
around, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone. I broke 1,000 hearts before I met you. I'll break 1,000 more, baby, before I am through. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone. Rich woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad. Bad. Bad.